Alright, this is Troy DeGroat. I'm going to run through a quick demonstration on document compare, and then I'm going to do document overlay, and then I'm going to end it quick with a tip. So hold out for that at the end. So as you can see, I've got two documents open here. I've got sync turned on, which allows me to zoom in, and the other one follows it. So I've got revision C and revision A open. I'm going to go to my document tab and go to compare documents. Select the two drawings that I have open and say OK. This is going to create a third document with the diff extension. So I'm going to come over here and I'm going to split my screen again and equal these out a little bit. Now you can see I have revision A, my diff, and my revision C. So what that did was it looked pixel by pixel at these two drawings, compared the two, and found anything that was different. So you can see here it was rounded in revision A and squared off in revision C. It clouded that difference. But the light fixtures here are a little harder to see. You wouldn't see those just looking around. It also found the spelling error in here that was changed. So I'm going to save this to my desktop and come back to that later. Close that. And then I've got these same documents here again. This time I'm going to go to my document tab and go to overlay. It's going to assign red to revision A and green to revision C. I'm going to say OK. Again, it's creating a third document called overlay, and it's placing those on top of each other like a light table used to be. So I'm going to close this one here. I've got revision A, overlay, and C, and now I can come in here and see those changes again with both overlaid on top of each other. Some of these, again, they pop out at you with the color changes, but some of these smaller changes, like the spelling, you may not see that when you're looking at the whole sheet. So the tip I want to show you here is one that I picked up at the Extreme Conference last year, and if you haven't been to the Extreme Conference, I highly suggest it. This is a good one from Ben Gunderson at Bluebeam. He showed this in his tips and tricks class. So now that I've got this overlay document created, I'm going to come down to my markups list and go to import, and I'm going to go out to my desktop and select my diff file that we just saved, and it's going to import all those markups. So now you can see I have the overlay and the cloud, which will really allow me to see any of the changes that are happening in these drawings, what's different, and cloud the whole thing, making it easier to see. So that's my tip today. Thanks for checking us out.